So you're both Democrats, you're twins. Do you have identical political views?
I wouldn't say they're identical. Obviously, like any two people, there are hardly any people that agree 100% of the time. So we grew
very
up
similar.
And,
yeah, you know, once in a while we'll find ourselves debating an issue, and
I always let him win. So that's the,
so your biggest disagreement politically.
What do you think the biggest one has been?
I don't know if I would describe it as a big disagreement, but I think just as issues as they come up when we're talking about them, we see them a little bit differently.
About strategy, about tactics, things like that. Yeah. Usually in terms of where we want to go on an issue is pretty similar.
Yeah. I wanted to ask you, because you're both Hispanic Americans, we have seen these protests over minority treatment. And this is, in this case, meant Black Americans, African Americans, by police. I want to play you just a portion of an interview the president gave on this that will the whole interview airing tomorrow. Here's a little of what he said.
When you're dealing with something as deeply rooted as racism or bias in any society, you've got to have vigilance, but you have to recognize that it's going to take some time, and you just have to be steady so that you don't give up when we don't get all the way there.
So the president saying, look, you've got to have some patience, and saying we have to also note the progress. I wanted to ask you, as Hispanic Americans, do you think that community has similar problems? Is there a brown on blue problem as well?
I believe that communities of color, particularly in our urban centers, do have, you know, trust issues with the police oftentimes. However, I wouldn't say that it's, I think that there's clearly been a stronger issue, a more acute issue in the African-American community when you look at the statistics of how many unarmed African-American men and boys are getting killed or getting injured or shot by police officers. And that doesn't speak to any one particular case, but I wouldn't say those are identical. However, they do have similar trust issues, and the statistics and the anecdotes that you hear in our cities bear that out.
Did you see it? I mean, you obviously have spent a lot of time in San Antonio, actually both of you. Do you feel a sense of tension between Hispanic communities and police?
There are a lot of the same concerns that you see in African-American communities, but I think it's also evident over the years that no community is immune from troubles with the police. In San Antonio right now, for example, there's a case going on where a white student was shot and killed by a campus police officer. And yesterday marked the year anniversary, and that case still has not been presented to a grand jury. So it's mostly communities of color, especially African Americans, but I think nobody is immune, and particularly younger folks tend to have these run-ins with police.
Right. Is there a federal solution? Or a part of a solution? There's no one.
Yeah, I think what we've seen come out of this really is three things: a retraining of police so that they're better able to handle these situations, body cameras, which are not a panacea but are a positive and strong step, and 84% of Americans support making sure that we have body cameras there, and then also changing the grand jury system.
And the president took a strong step, I believe, in Attorney General Holder making clear that the federal government is pursuing investigations in Ferguson and in Staten Island with respect to Eric Garner, but also that we're going to look at this in the larger context of the relationship between communities of color and the police. The funding for body cameras for local jurisdictions is a very good first start.
And also dealing with racial profiling is another thing that the
right.
president has spoken about.
I wanted to ask you as well about immigration, because you all are from Texas, and I believe your governor-elect is one of those leading the charge to file suit against the president for failing to enforce U.S. laws, in this case specifically immigration law. Your reaction?
It's very clear on the law, the merits, that lawsuit will not stand up. I expect that it's not going to, that Texas, that the Attorney General, now governor, soon to be governor, will find that lawsuit does not have merit. The president, by taking that executive action, is very clearly trying to address a broken immigration system and take a strong first step to fix it, focusing on felons, not families, ensuring that we do everything that we can to secure the border, and also give folks who have been here oftentimes for many years the opportunity to pay back taxes, to stay here with their family, to get right by the law, as he has said. But what Congress can do, and what Attorney General Abbott, soon to be Governor Abbott, should do, is to advocate passing a bill, passing legislation, so that we can have comprehensive immigration reform. The Senate has already done it, and now it's time for the House to do the same. Well,
in fact, you know, as a member of Congress, I'm hopeful that the Republican Senate and the Republican House will pass their own version of immigration reform.
But you don't think that'll happen, either
well,
one
yeah.
of you.
No, and even if I vote against it, I hope that they will pass their version, because I think what you could have is something akin to the 1990s, where you have a Republican Congress, a Democratic president, they pass their version of a bill, and that starts a negotiation with the White House, where Democratic members of Congress can be supportive of the president, but you have a two-way negotiation going on.
Mr. Secretary, I have to take advantage of your being here to ask you. The former Federal Reserve Chairman, Bernanke, said recently he had trouble refinancing his home loan. He thinks, and I think a lot of other people think, that the criteria has shifted from letting too many people get mortgages to being way too restrictive. Do you agree with that?
I agree with that. A few years ago, it was too easy to get a home loan. And now it's too difficult. So what we need to do is that we need to make sure that since the pendulum has swung from one extreme to the other, that we get the right balance, that we have the right safeguards in place, but that hardworking Americans who are ready and responsible to own a home can get a home loan. There are statistics right now that show that about 1.2 million folks could access good credit and responsibly pay on a home loan, but they're getting locked out of the system. At HUD, we want to do what we can to change that.
And finally, I have to ask, since this is a Family Dynasty show, which one of you do you think will want to make a run at the presidency first?
Well, it's definitely not me, so I'm in Congress. Yeah, I'll leave the question for him.
I think both of us doubt that that's ever going to happen, but both of us also are enjoying the roles that we do have. And it's been neat, you know, being twins. And as anybody who is a twin knows, it's a very unique relationship. And so we feel like we're having the time of our lives getting to be here and do good work on behalf of the American people.
And we'll see what the future brings.